This video is designed to show key features of the new National Weather Service's Hydrologic Decision Support Tool. The National Weather Service produces a variety of data sets in support of its Hydrologic Services mission. This Google-based map tool contains many of the data sets necessary to make water resources, flood, and emergency management decisions. The primary goal of this tool is to bring together a variety of spatial data products on the same map background for analysis and decision making. This gives stakeholders the flexibility to create customized maps and the ability to scale maps beyond a single RFC boundary. For this presentation, we are looking at the Hydro Decision Support Tool as shown on the front page of the National Weather Service's West Gulf River Forecast Center at www.srh.noaa.gov/WGRFC. Customers of the West Gulf RFC may notice that the familiar left blue menu is not currently visible. To turn on the left blue menu, simply click the tab at the top of the table of contents to bring the menu into view. Toggling that tab again will once again hide the menu and allow the map to expand across the full expanse of the web page. The default for the map shows hydrologic information, both observed and forecast, as indicated by the icons on the map. Mousing over a specific icon will allow you to view a hydrograph of both observed and forecast information where available. This information can be customized by the user so that you could instead look at a criteria table for a location showing the flood categories for that location, or turning off the mouse over options altogether. If you click on an icon, you are taken to the AHAPS or Advanced Hydrologic Prediction Service webpage for that specific location. In addition to hydrologic information, there is a large variety of other hydromet data available for viewing on the map. As an example, observed precipitation over the course of the last several hours or last day, and also for longer terms of 7 days out to 180 days, and also including month-to-date, water year-to-date, and year-to-date information. To view any one of these data sets, just simply click on the radio button to bring it into view. You will also notice that a legend for that specific data set pops up when you select it. That is controlled by the Products Legends tab at the top. You can notice that the default is set to show auto legends so that anytime a data set is selected, the legend for that data set will appear. You can toggle that off so that legends do not automatically appear when selecting data sets. If you want to select a legend for a data set while you have the auto show legends turned off, all you have to do is click on the little icon next to the data set again to bring that legend into view. So in this instance, we are now looking at 180 days of past precipitation along with the hydrologic icons across the West Gulf RFC region. In addition to observed precipitation, you can also look at normal precipitation for those same time periods and a percent of normal precipitation for those same time periods as well. To turn off a single data set, once you have turned it on, simply go back to that area in the table of contents and select off. You can also, if you have several data sets turned on, select turn off all layers at the top of the table of contents to turn all the layers off that you currently have visible. So once again, we can look at the normal precipitation over the last 180 days across the West Gulf RFC region. And since Auto Show Legends is not turned on currently, in order to see the legend for this data set, simply kick the icon located in the table of contents. The Hydro Decision Support Tool allows customers to display multiple data layers at the same time. So in this instance, I'm going to turn on 180 days worth of precipitation and turn on the legend for that data set. Now I'm going to go to current conditions and turn on the USDA Drought Monitor, which again brings up the legend for that data set as well. In order to see some of the data, since you have multiple data sets, you can use the slider bars to increase or decrease the opacity of specific layers. So in this instance, I'm going to go back to the observed precipitation and use the slider bar to decrease the opacity of the observed precipitation. As I do that, you'll notice that the drought monitor information comes more clearly into view. This feature allows, again, the customer to toggle between related data sets in order to gain more detailed information. To remove multiple data layers on the map, the quickest way is to click on the Turn Off All Layers tab at the top of the table of contents. Doing so removes all data layers in the map except for the default Hydrologic icons. So let's step through some of the specific data layers that are available for use in this Hydro Decisions tool. Again, we have observed precipitation from hourly time steps through 180 days year-to-date and water year-to-date. In addition, there is normal and percent of normal information that can be displayed. There's also forecast precipitation information, national data sets from the Hydrologic Prediction Center in Washington, D.C., as well as a mosaic of the River Forecast Center's QPF. RFC forecast precipitation is simply a mosaic of the forecast precipitation products from the different river forecast centers around the country. In addition to precipitation information, there is information on current hydrologic hazards such as flash flood warnings, the USDA Drought Monitor, which was looked at earlier, bringing that up again just to show. You can also look at radar and satellite information, and again, to turn off a single data layer, you can simply toggle that box again. You can also, once again, click off Turn Off All Layers to turn off all the data layers except for the baseline hydrologic icon information. In addition to current conditions, there's flood guidance information, the 5-day flood outlook potential from each of the river forecast centers. There's also a tab to click on, or rather a link to click on, the local RFC flood outlook product if you wanted to be taken to a separate page showing just that RFC's information. And there's flash flood guidance information at 1, 3, and 6 hours, showing an example of that. And again, if auto show legends is turned off, then you click on the icon to bring the legend up for that layer. There's also longer range information, such as the 6 to 10 day, 8 to 14 day, and monthly and 3-month temperature and precipitation outlooks produced by the Climate Prediction Center. Additional information, there is a local RFC products tab where you can be taken to a separate page showing specific RFC information depending on which page you are on. You can also look at severe weather information, the convective outlooks for days 1, 2, and 3 from the Storm Prediction Center, and also local storm reports. There's tropical information. During tropical season, you can display the forecast, track, and cone of errors for individual storms, as well as the 120-hour wind probabilities as storms approach the U.S. mainland. There are some geographic overlays, such as rivers, unique watersheds that the river forecast centers use to produce forecast information, county information, and road information as well. And there is a section on partner overlays showing the different FEMA regions and the different Army Corps of Engineer regions, as well as additional information from FEMA, such as hurricane evacuation routes, and also from the USGS. Finally, there is the last tab in the table of contents, which is about information on the Hydro Decision Support tool. There is an about page with additional information on how the tool was developed. There is a download page where you can download the specific data layers that are available in the tool. Most importantly, there is a feedback and survey section. This is a very simple 10-question survey, but we definitely want to hear your information about this Hydro Decision Support tool. The goal of this tool is for it to be an organic process, for it to continue to change to the needs of our customers. We highly encourage everyone who uses this Hydro tool to take the feedback survey in order to provide information on how we can change and improve the product to continue serving our customers' needs. If you have any specific questions about this Hydro page, you can also email the development team. That email address is sr-fwr.dsstool@noaa.gov. Thank you for watching this presentation on the new National Weather Service's Hydro Decision Support tool.